Hi, welcome back to the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this video, I'm going to show you 15 amazing shortcuts that you aren't using. Before we get started, I would like to ask you for two favors. First, click on that like button if you see a shortcut that you find useful and that will help you on your creative process. Number two is to click on that subscribe button if you're new to the Photoshop Training Channel. And if you're already subscribed or you're subscribing for the first time, don't forget to click on that notification bell so that you receive a new notification when a new tutorial goes up. That way, you don't miss any new tutorials. Okay, let's get started. You probably are already familiar with the clone stamp tool. It allows you to clone or copy pixels from one area to another. If you hold Alt on Windows, Option on the Mac, and click on your image, you will set the sample source, the area that you will copy pixels from. The preview will show you the size of the brush and the content that you will paint, but did you know that you can change the size, rotation, and the offset of the source by using a keyboard shortcut? If you hold Alt-Shift, Option-Shift on the Mac, and tap on any of the arrow keys, you will offset the sample source. Notice the preview updating as I tap the arrow keys. To rotate the sample source, you can hold Alt-Shift, Option-Shift on the Mac, and tap on the less than or greater than keys. Those are the same keys as the period and comma keys. And if you hold Alt-Shift and tap on the bracket keys, you will scale the sample source, allowing you to clone something at a different size than what you sampled. Keep in mind that these clone tool shortcuts only work with North American keyboards. If the shortcuts don't work for you, then you can go into Window, Clone Source, and use this panel to offset, scale, rotate, and even reset the clone source. When retouching, sometimes you may want to target either the highlights or shadows of an image. To quickly select the bright pixels of a photo, you can press Ctrl-Alt-2 on Windows, that's Command-Option-2 on the Mac. If you want to target the shadows of the image, you can then invert the selection by pressing Ctrl-Shift-I, Command-Shift-I on the Mac. If you create a color balance adjustment layer, you will see that Photoshop automatically applies a layer mask in the shape of that selection. Then you can make an extreme adjustment and you will see how the adjustment only affects the shadows. To invert a layer mask and target the highlights again, you can click on the layer mask icon, and in the properties panel, you can click on the invert button, or you could also press Ctrl I to invert the contents of the layer mask. Notice that the adjustment now only affects the highlights of the image. One useful shortcut for painting or compositing in Photoshop is the Lock Transparent Pixels shortcut. If you press the /key, you will lock the transparent pixels, and you will only be able to paint on pixels that are not transparent. Notice that I'm only painting on the contents of this layer, leaving the transparent pixels intact. To unlock the transparent pixels, press the /key again. This is the same example that I used on my Making Custom Photoshop Brushes video. If you want to learn more about how to make custom brushes from your photos, then check out this video. I'll place a link right below in the description. The Liquify filter is probably one of Photoshop's most powerful and used tools. You can find it under Filter, Liquify. With the Forward Warp tool, you can distort pixels by pushing them as you paint. You probably already know that you can reduce the distortion that you create by using the Reconstruct slider under the Brush Reconstruct options. It works much like the Fade command. As I drag to the left, the distortion decreases. Moving the slider to 0 gives you back your original image, and sliding it to 100 gives you the full effect that you applied. This is, of course, a global adjustment. If you want to target the reconstruction to a specific area, then use the Forward Warp tool while holding Alt, Option on the Mac, and paint on the specific areas that you would like to reconstruct. Another powerful distortion tool in Photoshop is the Puppet Warp tool, found in the Edit menu. It allows you to place pins on your image that you can then click and drag to distort it. If you don't get the results that you're expecting when you drag the pins, then hold Alt, Option on the Mac, while you hover over a pin. Then when you see a circle with a double-sided arrow, click and drag to rotate the pin and adjust the way the distortion is applied. And you can then keep rotating it until you get the results that you're looking for. If you want to watch a full explanation of how this tool works, then check out my complete guide on the Puppet Warp Tool. I'll place a link right below in the description. When painting, compositing, or retouching, you may need to use more than one brush, often switching back and forth from two or more brushes. This can become a tedious process if you have to keep going back up to the brushes panel to select a new brush. But did you know that you can press the less than or greater than keys to cycle between brushes? The less than key allows you to move backwards on the brushes list, while the greater than key allows you to move forward on the list. Another way in which you can save time in Photoshop is by reducing the time that you spend clicking on the layer thumbnail or the layer mask thumbnail. When you're working on a layer and you would like to switch over to the layer mask, you don't have to click it. All you need to do is press Control backslash. That's Command backslash on the Mac. Notice that the focus, the white outline, moved to the layer mask. And now you can continue painting, and that will of course affect the layer mask and not the layer. To go back into the layer, press Control 2, that's Command 2 on the Mac, and the focus will jump back to the layer thumbnail and you can keep working with the actual pixels of the layer. You probably already know that you can fill with your foreground color by pressing Alt Backspace, that's Option Delete on the Mac, and that you can fill with the background color by pressing Control Backspace, Command Delete on the Mac. But that you know that there is a shortcut that allows you to only fill opaque pixels so that you don't affect transparent ones. If you add the shift key to those fill shortcuts, you will only fill over the non-transparent pixels. For example, if I press shift alt backspace on Windows, that shift option delete on the Mac, I will fill with the foreground color but only affect the opaque pixels and not the transparent ones. Shift Control Backspace or Shift Command Delete will fill with the background color only on non-transparent pixels. When you have a selection active, sometimes you may run a command that disables it, or you simply disable it to do something else. If you want to bring back a selection, remember that you can press Control Shift D, that's Command Shift D on the Mac, to restore the last active selection. One fast and easy way to change the size and hardness of your brush is to hold Ctrl Alt on Windows, Command Option on the Mac, then right click and drag left and right to adjust the size of the brush, and drag up and down to adjust the hardness of the brush. Sometimes when working with Photoshop, you may get carried away and apply a bunch of adjustments, filters, or distortions that it's best to simply start from scratch. When this happens, you can press the F12 key to revert the file back to the last save point. If you haven't saved the document since you opened it, Photoshop will restore it back to the opening state. Another way of getting to the revert function is by going into the file menu and selecting revert. When working with text, sometimes you may need to adjust the spacing between two letters. One fast and easy way of doing so is to place the cursor between the two letters that you would like to adjust. Then hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and tap on the left arrow key to decrease the space between the two characters, or tap on the right arrow key to increase the space. This next example is not really a keyboard shortcut command, but it is a great time saver that I think qualifies as a shortcut. As you know, with the eyedropper tool, you can click on your image to select a color. But did you know that you could select a color from outside of Photoshop? If you drag the application window to the side to reveal any other application, you can click and hold inside of Photoshop to select the color. Then, if you drag out of the Photoshop window without releasing the mouse button, you will see that Photoshop will start selecting colors from outside the application. Once you find the color that you like, release the mouse button, and that color will be set to the foreground color inside of Photoshop. This keyboard shortcut is one that everyone should know. If you have been using Photoshop for a while, then you probably have run into this problem before. With a painting tool selected, such as a brush tool, you can see the preview of the brush. If you tap on the caps lock key, you would switch over to the crosshair cursor. This could be very useful in some cases, but if you inadvertently activate it, it can be extremely frustrating, especially if you don't know how to disable it. When I was just starting out in Photoshop, I actually uninstalled the app to try to fix this issue. Little did I know that all I needed to do to disable it was just to hit that caps lock key. Let me know in the comments if this has ever happened to you. It will make me feel a whole lot better to know that I wasn't the only one who ran into that problem. This next shortcut will be a bonus. This is a fun Easter egg that you can use to play a funny prank on a friend or coworker. If you click on the three-dot icon in the toolbar and go into the toolbar editor, you can hold Shift and click on Done. Doing so will replace the three dots with a banana. The icon doesn't do anything. It's just a funny little icon that surely will freak out your friends. To remove it, go back into the Edit toolbar menu and hold Alt on Windows, Option on the Mac, and click on Done. Let me know in the comments below if you're planning on playing a prank on someone with this Easter egg. Remember, if this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, then don't forget to click on that subscribe and notification buttons. If you enjoyed any of the shortcuts, then click on that like button and let me know in the comments below which shortcut that was. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you again in the next tutorial.